Hello guys, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. This video, we're going to talk about creating, well, using an HTTP client in Blazor WebAssembly. So what is an HTTP client? Now you know Blazor WebAssembly. You know how to create a progressive web application as you see on the screen. In the last video, we talked about how to create a project and how to populate a sample data. So you see from all these, we embedded or we did a hard coded and we have to or we display that data in the application like this. You know, what I want you guys to do here is I have done a video on creating API. So that's a RESTful API. This video, we are going to practice that. We are going to link our API in our application. So we talk about how to use HTTP client to consume the API that you have actually created. So you can check the playlist. Now watch RESTful API, that's the ASP.NET Core RESTful API development. And then that project was mainly focused on employee management. So you can just check that, okay? Then we come back to this project because for this, we have the API already, so API slash then employees. So you see we have a list of employees and that's what you can see here. Now we can pass in the ID as an employee to get the specific data. So here that's a search, as you can see. And if you want to search for maybe gender too, we can pass in search key, then query string. Let's say we want to search male, so gender equal to male, so equal to male, and this also working. So we say gender 0, so that's a male is what 0 as indicated in our program file. So you can see when you go to our program, let's go to gender dos, so that's the project.shared. Now gender.cs, you can see we have male, female, and other. Now male here, as soon as you have the mouse, what is the value there? It is 0. Female is 1. So when we call for gender equal to male, it means it's going to be 0. Or we can pass in 0 here. Now if you want female, female is 1. So you can pass in 1. And you can see we have, these are all females. So please check on that video first. Watch, it's about 10 videos or 13 videos under creating a RESTful API in ASP.NET Core. So we can actually come back and we are going to consume the RESTful API in this application by using the HTTP client. So you know by all means, I'll have a note for us to read from and you can also take a copy, take a look on that too. So let's get going. Now in here, what you're going to do here is Blazor WebAssembly uses HTTP client to call for data from a REST or RESTful API in a server. So once you have an API created, if Blazor wants to have data from it, it uses what? HTTP client. So we are going to consume the API that we have created. And the API is employee management. So it's an API focusing on employee management. Okay. Now, although, you know something, we can actually use the Blazor component to call the API directly and implement it. But we don't want our API to just have a lot of work. This is what we want to do. We want to use a wrapper service. Now, this wrapper service is going to call the API. And the API is going to return the data to the wrapper service, whereby the wrapper service is going to return the data to the Blazor component. So check it out. You see, I have a simple diagram for you to understand this. That is the Blazor component. So this Blazor component, example here is the data grid. So that's what I'm going to use here. So this is a data grid as a Blazor component. It is calling data from the wrapper services. So this wrapper service is going to grab the data from the REST API, whereby this REST API also depend on the SQL database for data. So database give it to the REST API. API provides to the service. Then the service give it back to the component, or that's the data grid component to display. That's what you're going to do. We have actually some steps that we need to actually follow. Once our API is ready, what you have to do here is step one. We have to implement wrapper, not our wrapper. Wow. So we have to implement the wrapper service to call the API. How do you implement it? Now the same, let's go to the client project. Now we're going to add a folder and we're going to name it at services. So Let's go to the client folder. So client folder, so you can see we have a client project here. Now this is for client. So let me close all this. This server, this is shared. So let's open the client one. Right click on the client. And now let's add a folder. So add a folder. Before we add a folder, let's take this off. Okay, so let's stop debugging. So solution explorer. Now client, right click. Now add new folder. And now what's gonna be the name? Services. Now when folder services is created, we are going to add an interface. So that's gonna be an employee service interface. So let's copy this. Let's add an interface which is going to hold all the methods that we are going to be using. So add the new item, and now here we're going to choose interface. So let's wait and see. Loading templates. So let's wait while templates are being loaded. So we wait. So let's click on interface, and now the name is what? I employee service. So click on add. Now you have this service. Now once you have this service created, the next thing to do here is we are going to create a copy of the I employee service. Okay, so let's see, you're going to create a copy of this. So when you go back to our project, now in our API, that is for the server, so you want to click on the server, and when you click on models, you can see we have our employee repository over here, and this from what? That is an interface. So we're going to copy this because you want to be using this to in our HTTP client in connection. So let's copy what we have here. That's the our employee repository. Now let's go to our employee services, and this service, let's paste this here. So once you paste this here, what is the next thing to do? It's going to just implement the Blazor project dot what shared, because this shared contains these classes, gender, employee, and department. All right, so we have this done. The next thing to do here is, once you have this, we have to provide an implementation for the interface that we have created, that's the employee services. So we're going to create a class, and that's going to be employee services. So take note, the interface is what? Our employee services, and now the implementation is employee service. So let's copy this. Let's go back to the solution explorer. Now with the same client site on the same services, right click and go to add. This time we are going to add class, not interface. Now the name is going to be employee service. Click on add. And now here is going to, this is going to inherit from our employee services. Okay. So here we have to implement it. So click on this and click on implement interface. So we wait for interfaces to be implemented. So you see it has implemented all the interfaces in it. By this, the first thing that you're going to take a look here is going to be only getting all products or getting all employees. That's the first one that you want to talk about. Maybe the other one you talk about it in the next videos going. Okay, so let's see, by implementing the first one, let's see how to go about that. So first of all, after implementing this, we are after inheriting from the I employee service, we are going to create this HTTP client. We're going to create a constructor, then we pass in this HTTP client, we inject it over here. Okay, so let's see how to do that. So let's copy this. So that's the employee services. So here, as we have it over here, once it has been implemented, let's see. So because we have public class, and now here you see we have the class employee services.cs. So first, let's copy this. And now on top, you're going to create a constructor and I inject the service. So on top here, that is where, let's paste this. So you can see we are using read-only HTTP client. Then we create an object out of it. You get a constructor from this employee service. Then we inject the HTTP client over here. Okay, so we have the injection. So now, while this is done, the next thing to do here is we are going to get all employees. So in the get employee, this is what you're going to do. Return HTTP client dot get from JSON async. Then we pass in. So let's copy this. And in our code, where are you having the get all employees? So that is a get all employees, less space this year. Now you know this is supposed to be async, so supposed to be async. Okay, now we have this. So return await HTTP client dot get from JSON async. Now it's going to return the list of employee. Now here we are specifying the you can see here is the API. So API, that's a route. So it specify the route here, API employee. So she's going to grab this from what? The API slash employee. So that's the route that's supposed to specify. So this is a way to consume this API, or to consume the API method called get employees. Once you have consumed this, what you have to do here is you have to install microsoft.extension.http, which has the add HTTP client extension method. So we go to the project, then we install this. So let me copy this. Then we go to our project. So our client, right click, and now go to package, manage Node.js packages. So let's wait for it to pop up. Then we are going to install that. So let's click on browse. And now let's paste what you have, what you copied over there, microsoft.extension.http. So let's wait to search. Now see, we are installing to the Blazor project.client. So that is over here. Let's see, we want only extension.http. So that's over here, extension.http. So click on that. Then we are going for version 6.0. So click on install. We are installing to the project.what, the client package, or that's a client project. So that's what we are installing to. Let's wait while it gets installed. So let's accept it, and it is installing the package. So it has what? Let's see, when you go to the output, you can see it has finished installing. All right, so once, let's close this. If it has finished, so after installing, what is the next thing? So we have to configure the HTTP client factory and its related services. Now you know you have to do that in the program.cs. So you see that as soon as you create an interface and a class, we have to actually link them together. So this is what you're going to do. So builder.services.addHttpClient. So you pass in the interface, then you pass in what? That is your service, the class. Then you specify the client. So the client we have for, that's a rocket ship. Now this will add the local host port automatically to the API. So you're going to grab the client or dot base address equal to new URI. So that's the uniform resources what identifier, builder.host environment.base address. So this simple code is going to bind the local link. So that's the HTTP localhost plus what, the port. So let's go to program.cs. So with the same project under the client, we go to program.cs. Now where we have this builder, we are going to paste this here. So let's paste this here. Now you see automatically, as soon as we installed the HTTP client, it's going to create this, but we don't want this for now. So let's comment this. So let's comment this, and now this is going to work. So we are adding the base address. So the base address is the URI, that's the HTTP local host and the port. Okay, we are adding, then we have the slash API from the interface, then we can actually move on with that. So once you are done with this, what's the next thing to do? Let's see. So we have to now inject the iEmployee service into the Blazor component. Now remember that we have created a Blazor already and the index.razor. Okay, so this is what you're going to do. You're going to inject it. And how do you inject it? Let's see. So let's go to our index.razor. That is the same client side. Let's first navigate to that. Solution Explorer. Now it has a client side. We have index dot, so let's click on pages. We have index.razor, so we are here. Okay, so we see that in the previous video we had this, we injected this, that's a sync fusion data grid. We have it here. Now the next thing to do here is we are going to inject this. So you see we have project name dot shared and the dot grid. So we have those as a namespace over here, dot shared, and now we have let's add the other one, two, to make it intact. So let's add that grid. Let's copy this and you're going to paste it over here. So instead of this star, we take off this star. Okay, so using sync3sync.blazor.grid, you can actually close that. So once you have that added, this, you have it already. So this is the code that we are going to implement. So instead of the first one that we need to use, you're going to clear that because currently we want to consume data from the API. Okay, so with this, we're going to clear everything here. So we're going to clear this and let's paste in this. Now with this code, you can see we are having this. So we are creating the public list. You know, we are creating a list object here. Now we are going to inject this our employee service. So currently it is not found. So let's go in there and inject this. So after injecting, you can see we are creating an object out of it. Then we are setting it to get and set. So we are creating this employee services, then dot get all employee, we convert it to list. We store the output into this employees. Remember that this employee is what we have used in the SF grid, that is sync fusion data grid over here. So it's going to get the same data over here as indicated below. So let's inject this. How do you inject it? You can see we have an attribute called inject, but you might also provide this in the import. So let's see. So let's import that file in the razor.what? Import.razor. So that's using project.client.what services. So let's go there and import that. So in here, we import that into our import.razor. So our project, let's go to our project. All right, so and let's click on Solution Explorer. So you can see we have import over here under the same client. You can see we have import, so import.razor, and now let's import this. So using now, this is going to be Blazor. So Blazor project.client.services. Now let's save this. Okay, so let's build this entity. So right click on Solution Explorer. And now let's build solution. So click on this to build a solution. All right, so you see we have problem here. Let's double click on this and now it is back here. So instead of this two legs, supposed to be, okay, so this is the two legs, right? So let's save this. Let's go back and build it again. So Solution Explorer, right click. Now let's build it again. So you can see that we have two succeeded, zero failed and one up to date. So now let's run application and see. So let's run our project here. Now let's wait and see. Voila. So you can see that we have a data from a database now. So this data, it is now coming from database. Because when you go to our application, you can see in our index, you can see we are not having the data, the sample data already. You are not having it. Now it is now coming in from the database. So that's a way to actually consume. Now we have consumed the API, the first method to get all employees. The next ones, we're going to talk about them in the next video. So for now, we've able to discuss how to use an HTTP client to actually get data from an API and return to the Blazor component. And specifically, that's going to be the SF grid or sync fusion data grid to display it for us. Thank you guys for watching. Let's give it a breakout and relax more. When we return, we're going to talk about different things altogether, and it's going to be interesting as well.